in this wonderful building. I was actually here about 4 months ago in my capacity of director of the Saint Cecilia Singers, and we came and sang a weekend of services here, which we thoroughly enjoyed. And before that, in 2013 and 2012, I did two lunchtime organ recitals. So this is my first organ recital here for about 9 years. A little bit bigger than I was 9 years ago, I have to say. But you'll notice when I go upstairs, the live streaming equipment is right next to the bench. So you might see the camera wobble a little bit. That wouldn't have happened 10 years ago. It's brilliant to play this wonderful organ as well, this absolutely fantastic, you know, arguably one of the best organs in the country, in my opinion. It's a wonderful experience to play it. And I'm starting off with the Auburn Sceptre March by William Walton, which I'm sure you will all know. And for obvious reasons, given what's happened in the country over the last few weeks, it seemed appropriate to give a nod to Her Late Majesty. So here it is, the Coronation March from 1953. And who knows what the Coronation March 2023 might be like. And then we move on over to the other side of the channel with Franck's wonderful Cantabile in B major, a lovely piece that demonstrates the trumpet stop on the swell section of the organ. And we're celebrating the 200th anniversary of Franck's birth this year. So I'm trying to play a piece of Franck in every program this year. A little Praeludium by Buxtehude, just to go back to North Germany 300 years or so ago, to demonstrate that this organ, you know, while a classic example of wonderful English organ building, can do Buxtehude in the North German school very successfully as well. So I hope you will agree when you hear that. I brought a little bit of home with me, although you all know that Elgar was Worcestershire rather than Gloucestershire, but I like to think that the two counties are basically the same place. And indeed, these two well-known pieces are arranged by one of my predecessors at Gloucester, Herbert Brewer. And they are two absolute gems. And then to finish off with the last movement of the Sonata Brittanica, the third organ sonata by Charles Villiers Stanford. And it's a wonderful sort of rollicking final movement of the sonata. And it's based on the hymn tune Hanover, which you will all know as O Worship the King. So enjoy that. So we're starting off with some Walton, and thank you very much for being here. It's wonderful to be back. Thank you.